We're going to discuss today arthrogryposis. Arthrogryposis is a word that many even physicians don't know. And it happens to be a catch-all term, which without one reason why people get it, of joint contractures from birth. So the joints get all, they can get deformed. Patients don't move their hands or their feet or their knees or their hips. And there's many different terms for arthrogryposis. Amyoplasia is what congenita is one term for it, AMC. Or amyoplasia is another term for arthrogryposis. But if you took 1,000 people with arthrogryposis, there may be 1,000 reasons for it. Some are genetic, some are viral when they were in utero, in the belly, or in gestation. And therefore, something happened that caused it. So the first goal when you see a person with arthrogryposis, or a child in my case, I see young children with arthrogryposis, is to try to figure out which category it is. Understand the reasons. With MRI, with the use of genetics from NYU, which is what we do, with studies and evaluations, we often can understand the reason why the person has this arthrogryposis, this joint contractures, these joint limitations. The next step is to treat this. And oftentimes in young childhood, we treat this non-surgically, both with casting, for club feet, which is when the foot's turned in, or for knees that don't extend or bend. We can often just do casting. However, the problem is that arthrogryposis affects multiple joints, hips, knees, ankles, and spines, and hands, and elbows, and shoulders. And basically, it affects joints in a very variable way. So you can have one person who has arthrogryposis, and you can barely tell. They walk fine, they almost function perfectly. And another person who is wheelchair-bound with no function. So that's a spectrum of disease, meaning that there's some very severe, some very mild. Some genetic, like Escobar syndrome, which have pterygium, which means they have webbing, and some where they just have one extremity involvement, or maybe just the knees are involved, or just the feet are involved. So I think that that's the first step. We diagnose what the reason is, and then we treat non-surgically. There are times, and that has certainly moved in advancement, we can do surgery for arthrogryposis during childhood to enable people who initially could not walk to walk. And I've seen this in children who present to me from the age of newborn, almost folded in half, to a child who presented to me at 12 years old and somewhere in between. And eventually with surgery, often combined with plastic surgery in our case. I use NYU plastic surgeons. And basically we... as a joint team with the physical therapists, the plastic surgeons, myself, and occupational therapists can often achieve great function in children with arthrogryposis. I don't think there's ever a reason to give up, but I think we need to have goals. We can't just operate, whether it's internal fixation, external fixation, soft tissue releases, minimally invasive, just casting without goals. I think we need goals, but understanding that the goals may change. Oftentimes, the worst time you see a child with arthrogryposis is at birth, when everything seems hopeless. And gradually, they can get stronger, and all of a sudden, we become hopeful that we can really achieve a very functional, good outcome. So what I ask parents is, don't give up. Don't be scared by arthrogryposis. It's a wide variety of disease. The kids can get better, and we often can achieve great function.